Let's separate. You go right, I'll go left. Can't be too far from here.
If he comes into sight, hold him fast. Many lives are depending on it. This must not end tonight. They must know that tomorrow is really gonna come.
Run and again.
Run and again.
Run and again.
Run and again.
Run and again. that's the bit. There's no need for grieving now. We must get on with the wedding supper.
You didn't get away, Mr. McLeod?
No, Archie.
Then where is he? I want to see my son. I'm glad you stopped him from his terrible intention, but I want to see him.
He's all right, Archie. He's in good hands now. Besides, it's best if he's left on his own for a while. Won't you join us in a bite of supper?
I'm too ashamed of him, Mr. McLennan. I cannot join you.
But Archie. Come, everybody. Back to the glen for some food and ale. The alarm's over now.
Angus, have you seen Tommy?
The American, Fiona? Oh, aye. I didn't think he came back with us.
Come, Fiona.
Sensation I'm hearing my own secret being told.
You mean you think you're in love with me?
Think? What good does thinking do? If I thought about it, it wouldn't make any more sense than the miracle. But what I feel is something else.
What do you think?
This is hard to say, but as I wandered through the I felt for just a fleeting moment, then I suddenly was free of being lonely. Then I closed my eyes and saw the very reason why. I saw saw a man and never know.
more serious in my life. I tell you, Jeff, one day I feel more part of her and all of this than I ever felt about Jane or anybody or anything back home.
And dear boy, that's because it is one day. Don't you realize that if you stay here, it's for always?
I know.
Do you know how long always is around here? It's one hell of a long time.
I know.
This can't be a trial marriage, you know. I mean, you can't change your mind after trying it out for 600 or 700 years.
I won't ever want to.
Absolutely positive. There won't come a time when you won't miss your family, your friends, the life you belong to. How can you know that now?
Because, well, here's where I know you'll think I'm crazy. Because I believe in her. And what's more, I believe in this place.
You do not. You just want to. This island voodoo town makes no more sense to you than it does to me. How can you believe in something when you don't understand it? Even a few days, you forget all about it, you won't feel a thing. That's the way a dream is.
What do you mean, dream?
That's what this is. A dream. Even now, you're not really moved by it, you just think you are.
How do you know?
Because I do. You, see that funeral here a few moments ago?
Yes, why?
I'm responsible for it.
What do you mean?
Harry beat me. I killed him.
Did what?
I killed him. Well, accidentally, of course, but nevertheless, I killed him. Out in the forest tonight, I saw him suddenly rush by me from behind the cliff, and then, without even thinking what I was doing, I stuck my foot out, and down he went. And then I heard his head get knocked with a very nasty thud.
My God, Jeff, I'm so sorry.
What in the world for?
Well, you must feel half dead inside.
Contrary, I don't feel a thing. Oh, except like going out.
But why don't you?
Because this is a dream. A good one for you, a bad one.
Wait a minute, will ya?
See, I've confused you, haven't I?
Yes, you have.
And if you believe as much as you think you do, I couldn't do that. I'll wait for you outside the town.
Tell me, what did he mean by that?
Mommy, he only tells me you want to stay there.
Tell me, what is it?
It's no good, Fiona. I'm leaving. And it isn't because I don't love you. I think I do. But I guess I just don't trust my own feelings.
You mean you're not sure you can accept everything?
That's about it, I guess. Fiona, it's not much time. You're going to have to hurry. Tony, don't be disappointed, lad. After all, remember, it's the hardest thing in the world to give everything. Well, usually it is the only way to get everything. Do you understand at all?
is that you got back from Scotland 4 months ago.
Well, I just decided I don't like it. It's not near as good as the whiskey mother used to make. Give me some gin.
What do you have with it?
A little boiler.
Yes, sir.
What time is it, Frank? I think my watch has stopped.
6:10.
I'd better be getting gone. And give me another one to take with me. I like to drink port and port.
Just about time for Miss Ashton to call.
Oh?
Jane Ashton? Mr. Albright's fiancée. Don't tell me you don't remember her.
All right, I won't. What about her?
Well, just about this same time every day. She either calls or comes in her boat looking for Mr. Albright.
She does, huh?
Yes. And from what I gather, she can't find him.
Well, I'm glad you warned me. I won't pick up and get out of here.
Don't you like Miss Ashton, sir?
Very much. Not when she's stalking Mr. Albright. I tell you, Frank, you scratch the surface of any woman and she'll enjoy it.
But where is Mr. Albright?
I don't know, Frank. He quit his job about a month ago, packed up all his parcels and vanished like... What do you do?
Like who?
Oh, that was the name of my brother who ran away.
Hi. Hi, Mr. Albright. Nice to see you.
Tommy! My old friend, Tommy!
How are you, Jeff?
Tommy's back. It's my old friend, Tommy.
Hello, Frank.
Where you been all month, Tommy?
Up on a farm with your manager.
A farm? Messing around with all that dirty dirt and everything? What were you doing up there?
Enjoying myself. A Ryan Soda, please, Frank.
Yes, sir.
If that's what you like, will you get married? Why don't you buy one?
I don't know if I want to get married yet.
Why?
Because, my dear old tank, I'm in love with someone else, and I can't get over it.
Oh.
The problem is, because I can't be with her, I can't be with anyone else.
That's why I would have went. So many things remind me of it.
When I'm with people and they're talking to me, they may say one little word that opens the door to a memory for me. All of a sudden, I don't hear them anymore. I'm a few thousand miles away with her. Slowly, I drift back to the conversation. They ask me a question, and I don't know what the hell they're talking about. I haven't heard a word.
Well, you must be fascinating company.
When I'm alone, it's easier.
Tommy!
Jane!
What a wonderful surprise!
Well, hello, Jane!
When did you get back?
Hello, Jane.
A little while ago.
How are you, Jane?
Jeff,
how are you?
No,
I wouldn't want to do that.
I didn't think so. And I told Mr. Jackson.
Things to find out what they mean.
Well, take a last look and let's